potential. And one of the strengths of Elise is she fits into any composition. You can put her in poke comps, you can put her in pick comps, you can put her in control comps. Like, she does everything very well. And that's one of the strengths to that champion, which is why you see her prioritized by so many of these teams. With Gragas being locked in for Super Hot Crew, we may not even see Yasuo. He may not feature for these two teams. They just might not play it.
Yeah, we've seen Caitlyn picked up in the previous game. Didn't work out too well for Tabs with Mr. Ryle, as he had an absolute impeccable performance, I think it's safe to say, in Saturday's match. He is up against Rocket, another Polish team. They know they struck down Meteor Makers, preventing them getting back into the LCS. Now can they do it again? Broke those Polish hearts. Lucian may well get locked in, but look at that. Malphite locked in instantly by Overpower.
So this is an all-in champion already, and you're gonna have some pretty good follow-up with the Lucian and Elise to dive as well. I'm almost expecting Yasuo to be locked in now, because there's the knockup power of that Malphite, which would allow Yasuo to land his ultimate last breath. Maybe I'm getting a little excited here, but I think that would probably be the way that I would see this going.
Well, Nami and Nunu being picked in there as well. So Nami alongside Nunu in the jungle for Impaler. We'll see how that one works out. We've not seen him on that one in the promotion or the previous matches. Of course, the final choice is going to be potentially the mid lane. It could be Team Malphite in the mid lane. We have seen it before with Alexic.
Possible.
But I'm expecting it to be something different. Morgana may be coming out here for the first time.
Okay, this I think... If it does get locked in, it's interesting, but I think it's a bit of a troll. Moops loves to play his Morgana as well, so I don't really expect this to get locked in. The one thing I do want to touch on what we've seen from Super Hot Crew already, with the Nami in there, with the Nunu as well, you've got a lot of disengage. You know, Absolute Zero plus that Tidal Wave. I also expect Super Hot Crew to do a lot of early roams and try to get towers fast, because Nunu, Blood Boil out of the jungle into a lane, that's going to be a dead tower. And if Super Hot Crew don't get a lot of towers very quickly,
ooh,
it could be very difficult.
This could be a Pantheon mid.
It has to be Pantheon mid.
This could well be Pantheon mid. I mean, it's either mid or top. I'm expecting it to be mid.
I would expect it to be mid myself. At the moment, Zazzus is sitting Flash Teleport, which is something you see on Malphites often. This is a very aggressive mid laner. And against somebody like Gragas, who is very strong early game with his, you know, attack damage buff that he gets from his Drunken Rage, I think that Overpower is going to be looking to get in Moops' face, throw a lot of spears down, and try use that guaranteed crit at low HP to try and stamp authority. If he doesn't at an early game, Gragas' poke with those barrels is going to make Pantheon's life so, so difficult. So expect ganks from Elise in the mid lane, as well as lots of early pressure from Pantheon.
And you know, we just heard Joe asking Youngbook, you know, look at you. Every team looks at these results, the fixtures, and says, these are games we can win. This is ballsy play for Rocket coming into this game, because this is one that both of these teams will be thinking, we have to pick up the victory here.
Well, Trundle won for Fnatic earlier. Mm. That was an oddball pick. I'm not going to call LeBlanc an oddball pick. We see her in the mid lane featured fairly often. Pantheon now, the last time we've seen it in Europe was, I think, Hercubot playing him in the jungle at the end of the summer split. Might have been spring split, but last year. And I don't really know how to expect it. He can either snowball very well, or he's going to fall behind Gragas and become ineffective and just a super squishy target that gets popped.
Well, before we get into this game, let's see who you guys at home here think will be coming out on top. According to lollysports.com, 52% of you have voted on Rocket, so a close, close decision between the fans.
One of the reasons I think for that is because Rocket have been locked in since the promotion.
Yes.
You know, Super Hot Crew, they only qualified on Saturday. As you've already said, they had to fly in literally 3 days before the event started. They haven't had the scrimming practice, the planning practice. Their pick and ban theory making hasn't had as much time. So I think that's a justified vote.
Absolutely. Of course, Super Hot Crew coming through, picking up a lot of fans, I feel, in their last minute playoffs. Right there on your screen. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Game 3 is underway of the 2014 Spring Split. Super Hot Crew as the blue team on your screens, up against Rocket as the red team. And well, Overpower on Pantheon. Will the man drop work? That's the question.
It has the potential to work. It worked for CLG last split as well. I think they put him in the jungle, if I recall correctly. And, you know, it works very well when you want to do lane ganks. A teleport plus Unstoppable Force plus Grand Skyfall or Mandrop from Pantheon is going to equal a dead tower or a dead gank. It's very, very powerful. So we'll see how Overpower can make it work. The early game for me is key. If Overpower falls behind early and his roams are not effective, you can basically write that champion off as dead weight.
Well, we see straight up, Impaler walks in, throws down that ward on red buff. showing exactly what they wanted to do. Didn't really get stopped either, so they managed to get that vision in early. Meanwhile, we didn't see Rockout trying to counter that one, so they have no vision wards whatsoever in the Super Hot Crew jungle right now, but I'm pretty sure they know where Impaler's going to be starting.
Yeah, they'll have a pretty good idea of this one. I quite like that deep ward from the Super Hot Crew. It'll allow them to potentially invade if they want to. And what we could see from Impaler in this game is a similar playstyle to what we've seen from Diamond Prox's Shyvana earlier. A lot of, you know, counter juggling, going in with that Smite in the consumer. And remember now, Smite is on a lower cooldown in the preseason and in, you know, to the 2014 season. So it allows that counter juggling to be even more effective.
One thing I'd like to look at is the two supports. They've both gone Doran Shield start.
They definitely know fighting's going to be happening. They've both gone for those Doran Shields. The difference being here that there's an exhaust for Mixer as opposed to the ignite for Vanda. And I think both of them are anticipating a lot of poke. Caitlyn and Lucian both very well known for the early game poke, and Lucian's already caught.
Aqua Prison catching out. Look at that. Damage on Salivar already taking him down to 200 hit points. Great start out from Mixer and Mr. Alice.
And it's what they did to meet your makers. They picked up first blood, I think, in both of the games against MYM. And this is a champion combo that could do the same. Mixer doesn't land the bubble this time.
Yeah, Van the sidestepping, but it does mean he took a couple of shots from Mr. Alice more than he would like. Salivar trying to get back in there. Vanda and Salivar. This is a partnership that worked very well for them up against the Ninjas in Pajamas. He qualifies, but look at this midline damage. Salivar over Paltrow already in trouble. The Ignite's running down. The Bournemouth barrel will do it, but instead he steps away. He's not backing away, though. He's chugging those pots.
Got the Crystalline Flask as well as that Biscuit to at least stock up some of his HP and mana, and this is what I'm afraid of. Overpower's keeping up in CS, but he cannot run the risk of an all-in from Moops taking him out. Please keep in mind, Ignite was burned by Moopsin at level 2. So if the fight breaks out, Overpower's got the summoner's advantage. Salivar down to 110 HP.
Yeah, Piltover Peacemaker just whipping across him. We also saw a little bit of poke coming out from Mixer as well. And they are really forcing them back here. We do see the two junglers meeting, though. It's going to be Jankos backing away from those, skittering away. Throws out that poison, tries to land the cocoon on towards him. But Impaler's going to get the slow down, continuing the pressure. Very aggressive stuff. Oh, the Aqua Prison would have landed. But instead, he flashes through, puts the exhaust down. Is it going to be enough? Piltover Peacemaker not going to quite land. There's first blood. It's Impaler that gets it. And now it's a 4-man stack on the tower.
They're not going to give up yet. Now Salivar's in trouble.
Salivar goes down. Will it go to Vanda? Is it too much? Too far? He gets the death sentence down. It's a double kill for Mr. Rallas. He does go down to the tower. It's a great start. Overpower trying to come down and react.
There's a lot of damage going down in this tower, and I think with Overpower getting in range, they've got to be a little bit careful. The execute damage from Overpower onto Moops was risky, so they decided to back away. But talking about Mr. Rallas and Mixer and the synergy they have, Super Hot Crew played with Heidel against SK Gaming at the promotion tournament, and they swapped him out for Mr. Riles. And they've both gone on record saying that this duo has some of the best synergy they've ever had as players. Just naturally, just by pot luck, it's worked out. And you see there, they realize that Impaler's going in, Impaler makes a move, they both react instantly and grab themselves 3 kills, only losing 1.
Very aggressive stuff and working out well. So that means he's going to be coming back to lane with that Vampiric Scepter and the boots already, as well as the Doran's blade that he had early on. Impaler setting himself up, trying to help out once again. He's already got 1 assist. Why not come back in along with that kill? We do see, of course, Mixer as well. He's going to be joining them any second now. This is going to be a 3-on-2.
Yeah, and the one thing I want to highlight is Mixer's gone for a Ruby Crystal as his first item back. He's expecting fights, and this might be it.
The fight is what he's going to find. Vanda immediately comes in, has to flash away from the Aqua Prison again. Mixer going aggressive, and well, Rocket, they're on their back feet in the bottom lane.
Super Hot Crew making it abundantly clear which lane they want to get snowballing. Also in the mid lane, Moops is holding his own against Overpower, so that's staying even. And if you look at Mimer, he's already got a lead over Zazzus' Malphite. So I think a very strong showing here from Super Hot Crew. We talked about how they want to shove towers early, and at 5 minutes 20, they've got a 3-man push on this bottom outer turret.
That Blood Boil doing work, and Mr. Rylas just constantly powering down on that tower. Already half the hit points gone off in just 5.5 minutes into this game. The top lane, as you mentioned, 41-27 CS. Mixer is just, Mimer is just bullying out that top lane.
I also think Mimer's Renekton will offer more threat in a prolonged team fight. As long as nobody from Super Hot Crew gets popped by that unstoppable force initiation, a Renekton's going to offer much more in a prolonged fight. The Super Hot Crew, they're not letting up. They definitely want this tower.
Impaler getting called into this one. The tower is going to hit him any second now. That's going to be the kill. And Rockout do get themselves one back.
Yeah, very nicely done. The double bubble not going to be enough. And now they're going to keep sticking onto Mixer.
Giant. Jankovic was taken very low. Jankos, I should say. Jankovic, I don't know where that one pulled in. He is Polish. Maybe that's his name. Who knows? But nevertheless, straight on. Trevor's died. He's died. I've lost him completely. But it is the bottom lane. Tower teleport coming in towards the top lane. But Zazzas at the moment is in trouble against Mimer. He teleports straight back in there and immediately has the back to his tower.
Zazzas is feeling the pressure right now. He's picked a Bruiser into a matchup that he's going to lose. Renekton offers more in the early game, can put more damage out, better sustain. And just using that teleport to pick up CS and not fall behind on levels is already a bad sign. You've got Overpower playing fairly defensively, but keeping up in CS in mid lane, which is very, very crucial once we start seeing those first Grand Skyfalls.
Yeah, we'll see if the man drops do manage to turn the game on its head. And of course, you know, Zazzas, we know he's going to be slow behind Mimer in the top lane. So no surprise, honestly. More importantly, I'm impressed that he's actually kept up with CS. He's only 10 CS fell behind. But Impaler has kept up the CS with Jankos, despite the fact he's been sat on that bottom lane for effectively the last 5 minutes.
Yeah, Impaler's doing a very, very good job. We talked about how he likes to play those aggressive junglers. We've seen him playing Fi, we've seen him playing Xin Zhao. This is a different style of jungle champion to play, and I'm actually excited to see it because I was worried he was a little bit one-dimensional. I was worried that if you took away the aggressive in-your-face junglers, he may not perform up to the same level. And so far this game, he's already demonstrating an ability to, you know, diversify his play. However, all that time he spent bottom, the tower's not down yet. There has been good defensive covering by Jankos, so, you know, overall, I think win for Rockass.
Aqua Prison catching on Sullivan again. The ace in the hole, Piltover Peacemaker follows straight through. Ace in the hole will be up in a moment, so I'm not expecting that one to just follow through as well. But it is all on the bottom lane. Super Hot Crew are keeping that pressure on. Once again, Jankos coming around. He's going to ward it out and maybe head on back down there.
We'll see where he decides to go. You know, has got even on CS, and he's been reacting to Super Hot Crew's play. We haven't seen Jankos actually setting up ganks or, you know, jumping in anybody's faces. So we'll have to see how he decides to start making an impact right now. The two top laners still left completely alone on their island. Nobody's gotten involved and, you know, began to battle them. And with Zazzas picking up that chain vest as his first item, he may just be a utility initiation bot, and they're hoping Lucian and Pantheon, as well as Elise, can close out team fights.
So, as the game develops, we are coming into the 9-minute mark, and we'll see who starts gaining advantages. Will someone start looking at maybe going for that dragon? We can see that Moops is making his way down to this bottom lane. I expect to see a bit of a dive. Nope, back straight off.
Yeah, I think they definitely want to pick up the tower here. You know, having four members there, plus that early Vamp Scepter on Mr. Rawls' Caitlyn, they want to get the tower, they want to rotate, and then they want to start pushing other lanes. But Rocket are doing phenomenally well at stalling this out. This is a composition we've actually seen, I think, several times. Nunu, very popular over in the GPL region. Not necessarily very victorious often, because once he falls behind, he doesn't offer a whole lot. And I think Rocket are doing good to prevent Impaler and Mr. Ross from snowballing the towers and the map presence out of control.
Overpower looking at maybe sidestepping, trying to go for that Grand Skyfall down the bottom. Of course, he can jump from quite a distance, so we'll keep our eye on that one. Doing a good job in this mid lane in terms of CS as well, because obviously every time Moops roams away from that lane, he's able to just steal a little bit of an advantage. And of course, it was an assist for Moops, which means the gold will still be even between the two. Did just see Vander, of course, that death sentence was about to land on Mr. Rallis, but the Aqua Prison instantly stopped it. So again, Mixer helping out his AD carry. This time, trying to get some of that gold reward on towards him with that talisman.
Yeah, and I really want to touch on the fact that we're seeing Nami. You know, Nami's a fringe champion that we haven't seen, you know, weakened or strengthened, but just other champions around her become more relevant, like your Leona, like your Annie, for example. And, you know, Nami's still in this unique position where she still offers quite a lot with her kit. She's got very good disengage. You know, her passive gives movement speed to her teammates as soon as she hits them with spells. And we'll see if Super Crew can make that mobility and the unique disengage of a tidal wave work for them.
I'm expecting to see Super Hot Crew potentially go for Dragon here. All four members of that bottom area went back to buy. So you can see that Impaler returns. There's beginnings of a Zhonya's Hourglass being picked up by Moops. Meanwhile, Bloodthirster almost completed by Mr. Rallis as well. And now the Sightstone being picked up by Mixer. One full vision, so I'm expecting that Dragon to be started off soon.
No GP10. So Mixer's anticipating being jumped on by Elise Pantheon and Malphite. So he's gone for a lot of HP, got that Doran's, got the Sightstone already. But he is going to be behind in gold generation. So once again, if Rocket keeps stalling this out, keeps slowing the game down, extend this laning phase, Rocket will come out in the lead because they've got passive gold generation on their support. Even though they're behind a little bit in CS, that'll begin to even itself out.
There's the pink ward thrown down. They've got a good ward vision around the white as well. So the blue buff area completely covered off. Super Hot Crew once again, three-man stacking down the bottom. That's going to pull Jankos straight down here once again to help out in this defensive duty. You're going to see whether they can pick any kills up. And as it is, they're stepping away and they're not keeping that pressure down.
They're not actually sticking to it. And I'm wondering to myself now if Super Hot Crew maybe backed away from the decision to push those towers. You know, maybe it hasn't worked thanks to some very good defensive play by Jankos. You can actually see him hanging just out of sight. The hook does land on Mixer. They're not going to go in for this one just yet. And I think overall, it's just been a very defensive play from Rocket and Superhockey trying to find a way in. It's not working for them.
Mimer is just farming out between the two top turrets. It's what we saw in the previous match, doing very well by Youngbuck, keeping Wicked in all sorts of trouble in the top lane. Zazzus is not too worried about that, though. He's got his passive, of course. Don't forget, he can just tank out these minions for days in that top lane area. So they're not really engaging with each other. Jankos does take down that pink ward, so a big investment there from Super Hot Crew. Not really working out for them.
No, not at all. You know, the hook goes a little wide, but now we're starting to see a CS difference. Impala, with all the attention he's trying to place in this bottom lane, is now 20 creeps behind that of Jankos. And Jankos has been able to defend that tower as well. Truthfully, that's really the only story that's emerging from this. You've got your two tanky top laners on their own island, battling it out, trying to CS as best they can. Mime is coming out in the lead. The mid lane, Overpower is in fact winning the CS game. And I think Moops is afraid of being collapsed on, afraid of being jumped on, and the full combo of Pantheon taking him out. So it's actually a very passive start to this match.
Not blue buff start there, but we do see Rocket coming straight in. It was Jankos immediately pulling that red buff back towards him as Impaler tries desperately to pull him back around, but it's not really working out for them, and he will step away the moment Zazzus came back down the bottom there. He is in trouble. He's going to get a couple of spidlings chasing behind him, but he will just walk away. Can, of course, get that speed boost with the Blood Boil.
Yeah, the movement speed just enough to get him out of range there. You did see Overpower and Zazzus trying to respond, but we also see the first item pick up there from Impala being that Ruby Sightstone you highlighted earlier, and two Sightstones on the team. You almost expect Super Hot Crew to having a lot more wards. They've got some good vision around the red buff of Rocket, but very little around the blue and the dragon area. So I would expect to see them maybe even picking up the likes of sweeping lenses on those two champions, clearing up vision, getting a ring of vision, and then invading to try to take some, you know, consume steals in conjunction with Gragas. There's a lot of steal potential between those two champions.
Yeah, neither team actually even thinking about going for that dragon. You know, don't forget, Zazzus has that teleport, yet to use it. We're coming up to the 14-minute mark. He's yet to go aggressive. We do see the Aqua Prison landed on Zvander, but it's not going to do a great deal. He does have vision, of course, with that ward in there. But Mr. Rylas and Mixer, as you mentioned, they decided to step it back, it seems, because of the great defensive work that Rocket did early on. But again, Rocket are so passive, just as we saw up against Ninja Pajamas. It worked out for them then, so let's not criticize the play. But they are really playing this one out.
On the exact same token, Super Hot Crew have put a composition together that is not necessarily capable of breaking this defensive play. They are not very strong at diving. Maybe if you get Gragas and Renekton in and involved, yes, then it becomes a different beast. But you don't have like a Vi or a Lee Sin or an Elise that can go under the tower, take some damage, break the aggro, and then get out with a kill. So if Rocket want to play patiently, stall this out to the late game, and then pick up a win like they did against Ninjas in Pajamas, can't fault them.
Aqua Prison once again finding its target, picking the AD carry, Selavar. And once again, Jankos comes straight down this bottom lane, helps out and clears out every little bit of it. It is very low now, that bottom turret, though. There is wards being placed once again in the bottom, keeping all the coverage down there. Jankos is going to come around. Feely may well be warding out, running towards that. No, he was just checking there was any pink wards. There's no pink wards around that dragon area, so he just backs it away again. Sorcerer's Shoes, though, being picked up by Jankos.
So that's not too uncommon. We do see some damage onto Selavar. He does manage to get away, and there's a tidal wave.
Tidal wave comes in. Is it going to be enough? Selavar has to use the Cullin. He lands on towards Mixer. We do see the Grand Skyfall coming in. That's going to be Jankos going very deep alongside him. Overpower does get in there, gets down the AD carry of Mr. Rylas. Now they're going to come in, though, but in comes the Gragas. Moops comes in, cleans up, but it was a double kill picked up by Overpower. Gank successful, but will they follow through?
2-for-1, and the first time we see Pantheon roam, he manages to grab himself some kills. Nice reaction from Moops, and I think if this tower falls, overall Superhot Crew won't be too unhappy. What they need to be careful of is making sure they recall, heal, and maybe get back in position for Dragon. If Jankos and Selva wanted to rush it, they may have been able to, but it doesn't look like that's the call right now.
And these two top laners refuse to face each other in the battle. Instead, they will just keep on walking past. They both got Sunfire Capes, they both got Doran Shields. Neither care about each other.
I almost would have liked to have seen Zazzus use the teleport, because if he had, they may have been able to get more with the Unstoppable Force, and they would have had even more people down in this bottom lane. As you see Moops trying to defend, Jankos and Celebo too late. I think there was too much indecision on them getting to this dragon, and now all of a sudden they're outnumbered.
Yeah, Grand Skyfall not available. You can see Moops and Mr. Alas and Mixer all coming in. They've got all the M's as well, because Mimer's going to come down here as well. Ace in the Hole comes out towards Overpower, forces him away from this mid lane turret. Uses that Spears to try and clear out the minions, but this is going to be another turret being picked up by the Superhot Crew.
Oh, Mixer's got caught.
He has got caught. Aqua Prism catches on towards him. Look at the damage. Quickly bursting straight on towards him. Explosive cast being used defensively. Teleport finally coming in from Zazzus, but a little too late.
A little too late indeed. Keep in mind, Unstoppable Force is available, and the Culling is about to become available as well. So if Rocket want to re-engage on members of Superhot Crew, they have the tools available to get more kills. And if they can keep landing picks like they just did now, they can defend more turrets. They can even go for dives themselves. Remember, Zazzus has his ultimate. Keep that in mind.
Well, we've got two members splitting off here, playing defensive duties. There is going to be Impaler getting caught out here. They've got the dragon down already, has to flash away from it. And five members of Superhot Crew have to back away there, because Rocket easily picked themselves up a dragon. Great turnaround! If that's going to be Unstoppable Force, Mimer gets caught out. He goes down. That's an easy pick.
That is exactly what Rocket want to keep doing over and over. Allow the Unstoppable Force to buy enough time for all of the damage dealers of Elise, Pantheon, and Lucian to close it out. I think that was a Grand Skyfall animation.
It got cancelled, I think. I'm not sure.
It looked like
it. He definitely used it. It's on a quick cooldown, so he cancelled it out there. Overpower thought about going for it. They had a ward down there, thought he maybe get himself an easy kill. Instead, he realizes he has to defend out this middle. I didn't see whether Aqua Prism caught him maybe when he went for it. But
he just cancelled it, walked away, basically. Done a quick rewind. But nevertheless, Overpower is going to be able to use that ultimate in the not-too-distant future. He's gone for a full penetration build right now. Got himself the Brutalizer as well as the Last Whisper. So nobody's armor is going to matter.
Yeah, two items for that one. He's got the Last Whisper and Brutalizer, like you say. 2-1-2, he's got himself up to. And, you know, after a great start by the Superhot Crew, they were 3-1 up in kills. They're already on the back foot, 6-4. They got the bottom lane being shoved in. Salavar using the Cullen to clear that one out. We do see Jankos back in their top lane, taking the red buff. Everywhere, it is going to be Rocket starting to pick up advantages.
Yeah, I really want to highlight the fact that Mixer still has no GP10s. He's rushed a Ruby Sightstone as his first big pickup, so he is anticipating being jumped on and is anticipating those fights with, you know, the all-in power of Rocket. But the longer this game goes, the more, the better the position Vander's actually going to be in, especially once he manages to get that, you know, Talisman of Ascension, gets that movement speed buff. The Nunu, 1-1-2, it was their second-to-last lock-in. I don't think it has worked out for Superhot Crew right now, and they're going to need to try and find sneaky ways to take towers. They're a little bit risky and squishy that if they get jumped on by Rocket, they'll die in a straight up fight. So I think the goal now is to get good vision with those sightstones and take a tower quickly before Rocket can respond.
Well, as the tankiness progresses from Rocket, we do see Superhot Crew trying to get a little bit more damage on there. Spirit Visage though is going to be picked up by Mimer, so almost standard build for Renekton's these days around the world. If you're watching this as a budding pro player, then you can learn a lot from some of these players in the LCS. And of course, the builds they use are not always what you'd see on a guide, because they do counter to what they're up against.
Yeah, it depends exactly on what your opponents are building. For example, you know, I keep hopping on about it, but the GP10 side of Mixer, we're also going to see Mr. Rolls working his way towards a static shift to get some control. And it does look like Malphite's coming down. Grand Skyfall in the mid lane!
Going on towards Mr. Rolls. Unstoppable Force finds him! He's already used that barrier, and he's just not enough, because the damage is pounding down. The double penetration of them is working wonders. They do manage to get 4 kills for 0.
Rocket just melt the Superhot Crew. The wombo combo like we've never seen before. Unstoppable Force into the Grand Skyfall, and then just allow Pantheon and Elise to chase down. This is a 20-minute Baron. There is nobody to defend. Mimer, if he tries to challenge, will just get shut down. And as long as Rocket balance the damage, this is a very, very early Baron.
A very well-worked team fight there. The go command was given, that was for sure, and that will be the first Baron of the game. 20-minute Baron, that's the quickest we've seen so far here in the European Sprints. But of course, it is only game three, so let's not get carried away. But
it still counts. Just the fight, and this is exactly what I'm talking about. Take a look at all of the burst damage. The Tidal Wave actually holds members of Super Hot Crew together, and it's just chase after chase. Celavar actually gets that movement speed increase from his Ardent Blaze and carries on chasing down, and exactly like you highlighted in the fight, the magic penetration from Elise plus the armor penetration from Pantheon equals an unhappy Super Hot Crew.
Absolute fantastic stuff. And Mixer almost baiting his own team in with that Tidal Wave, like you say. It is going to be the middle lane turret that's potentially going down. Nope. Explosive Cast will clear the wave out, and that's going to force him away. But it is going to be a barrier for the next 4 minutes for a Rocket. And Super Hot Crew, after an exciting, explosive performance getting through Meet Your Makers, are really in trouble here.
Yeah, and Rocket's ultimates are almost all available as well, so the potential of that massive combo is once again there. What you're also going to see, because Teleport is available, Rocket can afford to do a split push. Malphite is up top, Pantheon's down low, so they can go for this one top, three mid, one bottom, because they have global and quasi-global abilities that allow them to close that gap.
Well, we'll see whether that works out. Overpower, of course, can take those towers down very quickly. Now building up yet more damage on him. We'll see what he goes with next. Frozen Heart being picked up by Zazzas. Now, not a lot's going to worry him in terms of AD, that's for sure. It's going to be ability power. They are going to possibly dive in. Mime is in trouble. There's the Unstoppable Force. The Repel comes through. It quickly gets flayed away and taken down. It's Jankos that takes the kill.
Zazzas was tanking that tower the entire time, and you never felt that he was in threat of getting shut down. Overpower wants to play with Mr. Roz, but now it's 1v2. Question is, can he get away with this?
Oh, I don't think he's going to. He's thinking he's bitten off a little bit more than he can chew, or has he? Ace in the hole will come through. That will be Mr. Rales taking it down. But while this is all happening, they're just ignoring what's going on, and they're pushing the middle and the top.
He pulled four members of Super Hot Crew down to the bottom lane to deal with him. The top outer tower went down, some damage in the mid lane, and now the Rocket members are rolling themselves around to the top lane. Once Celebrate gets here, this tower's going to go down.
Explosive Cask has to be used to try and clear them away, but it's not going to work, and they do take a tower. So one death for two towers, I'd take that any day. 4-1 now for Rocket.
Well worth it indeed. And you know, the thing that we were talking about Super Hot Crew being so good in the mid game in our pre-game discussion is what Rocket's doing well here. They are roaming well, they're rotating, they're playing the tower game right now. Even though Overpower got shut down, and you can say, hey, that's an overconfident play, it was calculated. The rest of his team were in there pushing towers in the mid and the top lane, taking advantage of not having defenders. Now, luckily, Super Hot Crew have a little bit of time. They want a challenge for Dragon, but it looks like everybody from Rocket's coming in.
Teleport used by Zazzas there just forces them away. One single teleport, everybody quickly scattered to the wind. And Rocket has bought them time for everybody else to join there. Black Cleaver being picked up by Overpower. That is danger signs for Mr. Rales. If he gets caught, if Mixer gets caught, he will go down. But look at this, the jungler, Jankos, 5-1-4, Rabidon's death cap on Elise. Why not?
Why not? When you're that far ahead and you've got so many squishy targets, you can pop Nunu, Gragas, you know, Caitlyn and Nami, you may as well go for that damage. There is no magic resist being built up here with the exception of Mima, and Elise isn't going to be focusing her. So as soon as the Unstoppable Force hits, Elise is just going to repel to a squishy target, kill it, and then move on to the next one. So very nice combo that Rocket are making work for themselves. And remember, they were the ones defending early on. They were the ones on the back foot defending their bottom lane tower.
And I wonder if Zazzas is going to be looking at this and thinking, you know what, I wouldn't mind a little bit of ability power myself. Go a little bit Darien and start picking up maybe a Rabidon's death cap of his own, because that will turn that Unstoppable Force to a mean beast. That bottom lane is being pressured by Overpower. The top lane, we can see the AD carry of Celavar up there pushing in towards the inhibitor turret. Somebody's got to react to him right now, because he's going to get some free time on that turret.
Nobody from Super Hot Crew is strong enough to duel the members of Rocket, so they cannot afford to put like moves there against Pantheon. Pantheon should be able to just kill him, you know, avoid that cast by a flash and take Moops out. So what Super Hot Crew have to do is try to split their forces up. Jankos is making his way to the mid lane now, and Rocket once again just playing this numbers game. 1-3-1. They've got members across the map pushing all at the same time.
Yeah, you can see Celavar is continuing to shove the middle, the top lane. Mr. Rala is doing a good job of forcing him away though. That's damage taking it to half. That's going to force him out of this one. It may buy the rest of the team some time to take a breather as the Baron buff wears off. But look at this, Mima trying to get in there, trying to bully him out. Overpower quickly turns around, puts those spears down, shreds his health, and the middle turret is picked up.
Super Hot Crew are trying to stall until Baron is worn off, which it does look like has just happened. Now they want to try to pick a fight, but they're already 12,000 gold down. It's very difficult to see how they can win a team fight without a perfect barrel knocking everyone away and killing a priority target like Selavar Overpower and then trying to win 5v4. But it's going to be very hard going. If Super Hot Crew group up as 2-3 members, you will see an instant unstoppable force coming out of Zazzus.
And here's Rockout. They've grouped up in towards the middle inhibitor turret. They've realized that one member stepped away. They've got the Grand Skyfall available from Overpower. He has now backed off to base. He's going to buy himself. Oh, wow. He's getting more health in there. He's becoming an absolute beast with the Warmogs. He's going to get yet more health. The red buff being picked up as well. He's going to be a beast when he joins the fight again.
There's nothing that Super Hot Crew can do to deal with Pantheon right now. With the amount of HP he has and the damage that he's putting out, you know, a Last Whisper Bloodthirster from Mr. Oz is going to help survive a little bit, but not enough to get through the Heartstreaker Strike, the stun, and all the spears that are coming down. So very, very good position here from Rocket. I think they've also got a very good diving team as well. Multiple stuns and some very hard CC. So they should just group up, take advantage of this very strong lead they've built up, and force more objectives down 5v5. The Super Hot Crew simply can't do anything about it.
And it's a 12,000 lead they've built up here. They've just absolutely forced Super Hot Crew away from every single tower, every time they come into there. You mentioned it earlier, nobody can do a 1v1 right now. Everybody is keeping their distance. 28 seconds till the Baron. We do see the Wraiths making a really squealy noise there. And
very unhappy.
They're not appreciating Malphite beating them up, slapping them, as I believe the players like to call it with Malphite skill.
It's the best way to describe it. It is just once again some more farming coming out there from Zazzus. He's up to 10,000 gold, 2,000 above his lane opposition Mimo. Just shy of that. And as we started talking about Rocket, now I think they need a group. The 3-1-1 is great. It has been working for them, but you've now got an immense lead. And I would love to see them actually just forcing a 5v5, forcing a dive. You look at Zazzus' build, he's got a Void Staff in there. Jankos has got a Void Staff. I mean, that's basically a mid lane AP. He's got 100 CS higher than Impaler's Nunu. And I don't think the decision making from Super Hot Crew to go for that fast tower push, not only did it not work, they haven't adapted to the failure, and Rocket have just pulled further ahead.
That's a jungler with 357 ability power. This is going to be a Baron for free. There's nothing they can do about it. Overpower not needed for that one. He's continuing to just keep that bottom wave clear. And Super Hot Crew, well, they may have had a dream to get in the LCS, but they're having a nightmare in game one against Rocket.
Yeah, their mid lane of Moops is 100 AP behind the jungler of Rocket. And that really tells the story. Now that Baron has been secured, Rocket finally feeling they can actually start to group up. This is going to be a four-man push on the top lane. Keep in mind, Grand Skyfall is available here for Overpower's Pantheon. So he should be able to reach the top lane from that inhibitor outer lane. And it's really just a matter of time. I think we need to just keep our eyes on Zazzus. He's going to be the one that'll pull the trigger if someone gets caught.
Well, he's just standing there taking it. Wow. One little bit of damage onto Mixer there. Just chunked him straight down. Selavar getting some free time to hit this turret. Of course, Aqua Prison landing on the right time. Explosive Cask was used there and really didn't do a lot. And Zazzus actually just stands and laughs while he takes tower hits.
Yeah, pulled that Explosive Cask a little bit shallow. It actually knocked Zazzus into the wall as opposed to into the team. And truthfully, that probably saved Super Hot Crew. If Zazzus and Malphite had gone closer to Super Hot Crew, he just would have unstoppable forced them. We do see Mima having a tough time dealing with Overpower. He cannot get through the HP. And, you know, Mima's being forced back. It's a 4-on-1 push Rocket, getting some damage on the turret, but they're definitely not focusing it down right now.
Mima's losing so much health in this bottom lane. You can see, once again, the spears from Overpower. It's forced him back to the fountain now. Is this going to be the time they're going to pull the trigger? Will they go for it? No, because Jankos is back getting blue buff.
Yeah, he's going to steal that buff away. I think they're a little nervous. I think, you know, maybe they don't realize quite how far ahead they are.
In fairness, they've got no reason to push into it now because they have complete dominance. There's literally...
Oh, there's a teleport coming
giant,
up from Zazzus.
Giant fail. It has to come out. It's going to be the Home Guard teleport catching on towards Mr. Ralas. Dead in seconds. Straight away poured out of it. That's going to be the inhibitor turret, the first one of the game. You said they were waiting to pull the trigger. That was it.
Now I realize why they were waiting. They just wanted enough gold on Zazzus so he could buy Home Guard boots and make a flashy end to the game. That's the first inhibitor is now fallen. You can actually see that Overpower has joined the rest of his team. So now all of a sudden Rocket are just going to be able to tank this tower up, drop this one down, It does look like they are hunting for targets. There's going to be more turrets for Rocket. He's got in.
He's jumped on towards Moops. Moops goes down. Mimer, the tankiest member, just can't take any of it. A quick rappel comes in. Jankos catches on towards it. It's a double kill for Salavar. Second inhibitor of the game's going to go down, but they don't care. They don't want it. They're going to go straight for the Nexus turrets.
Yeah, going to turn straight into the Nexus turrets. This is a 5v3 as it stands, and Rocket are going to pick up the victory.
Absolute fantastic stuff for game one for Rocket. They do take down their fellow qualifiers, Super Hot Crew, in grand style. It started off well for Super Hot Crew. They look so good, and it's Rocket that dominated game three.
The Nunu pick did not work. It's that simple. I'm afraid that early push tower, it was held off so well by Jankos' defensive play on that Elise. And once the Super Hot Crew stalled, they never found a way to get their engines rolling again, never found a way to get themselves back into this matchup.
Well, they were once a team, now they've got a home, and it is in the LCS. They have picked up their first victory, and honestly, overall, a great team performance. We talked about the defensive duties down the bottom. They were 3-1 down, Mr. Rollers and Mixer pulling it on them. But every time Jankos came down there, helped them out, held the tower for so, so long. 20 minutes, I believe it was, before that bottom turret eventually went down.
Yeah, and we've seen it. Like I said, every time we see this Nunu Caitlyn combo, and you ideally want to get a tower, rotate, get a tower, if that first tower doesn't fall quickly enough, there is nothing you can do to pull yourself back into it. Nunu does not offer a thing against a Pantheon who's going to leap over you, a Malphite that's going to dash over you. Yeah, you're slowing the ground, but that only affects a tiny number. And even Lucian, his Relentless Pursuit, it gets rid of slows. He's just going to, you know, shake it off.
And talking about those champions, game three, yet more different champions. The 2014 season already throwing out a whole mix of champion choices right now. And that's a completely different pick. I mean, that's a ballsy bit of play coming out from Rocket in game one to pull out a Pantheon in the mid lane.
The thing that's fantastic about it is it sows the seeds of doubt in everybody else that's going to play them. The moment you see a Pantheon, Malphite locked in, who is a fairly, you know, standard top laner, maybe not in this meta, but you see Malphite, you know what to expect. The whole team starts going, do we pick Elise now? Do we want Pantheon away? Is Pantheon going to be a threat? Because that combo worked very, very well. You know, last year it would have been a Sona Crescendo, you know, Curse of the Sad Bullet Time, yada, yada, yada. This could be a combination that can work multiple times.
So going back to the start, picks and bans, we saw obviously Renekton was the first choice for Mimer. Do you feel at least possibly should have been picked up following that? Because obviously that was the champion that seemed to work for Impaler, the fallback after Vi.
I would have picked Elise first. I think the Renekton had a strong laning phase, which is great. He did well against Malphite. That's expected. But it didn't convert because the rest of his team fell so far behind. If Impaler had had Elise as opposed to Nunu, two things would have happened. That whole push tower strat wouldn't have been the focus of the comp, and Impaler could have had an impact in the mid game once those big burst damage came down. But unfortunately, you know, the committed composition decision was for this push attack speed thing, and it just didn't work out for Super Crew.
Well, a fantastic start for Rocket in their first game of the LCS. Commiserations to the Super Hot Crew. Of course, there's plenty of games to go. And when we come back, the team experience of Fnatic will be taking on the newly assembled superstars of Alliance. But first, Shox will be speaking to Overpower from Rocket. The opening day.